Hello, my dear students. Today I'm going to explain you fourth chapter, Early States of Political System in India. We got information about the political system and institution from the Vedas, epics, and Buddhist text. In the Rigvedic period or Vedic period, the form of statehood was similar to that of Kabyle rule. The Rajanya was the head of this rule. He has to be elected from the people. Political organization like Sabha and Samiti also existed that period. This community was also called Vish. Afterwards, different types of political systems were implemented in India. Now let us study Janpath. As per the Vedic text, Aryan tribes were known as the Janas, which were the largest social units. The term Janapada, composed of Janas, means people or subject, and Pada, foot. Janapadas were the earliest gathering places of men, merchants, artisans and craftsmen. Janapadas became the major realms, publics or kingdom of Vedic India. A Janapadin was the ruler of Janapada. Ancient Sanskrit texts like Ramayana, Mahabharata and numerous Puranas refers to many Janapadas of ancient time. Janapadas was the area or place of persons habited. The word Janapada is used in the sense of state. Janapada was a system that was very unique from the clan society of Rigveda period. It includes the states of different groups like Kuru and Panchal. Now let us see Mahajanapad. The 6th century BC onwards, the widespread use of the iron in eastern UP and western Bihar created conditions for formation of large territorial states. With these developments, Janapadas became more powerful and turned into Mahajanapadas. There were 16 Mahajanapadas during 600 BC to 300 BC. Which are mentioned in early Buddhist and Jain literature. Those were as follows. There are 16 Mahajanapadas are shown in the above table. Anga was one of the earliest of all Mahajanapadas. This was around the Gangetic Plains. This state was named by various names in the Atharva Veda. Magadha was a powerful kingdom and was run by Bimbisara and Ajatasattu. It was covered the modern district of Patna, Gaya and parts of Shabadvidur's earlier capital at Ragirai. Vaji. The Vajians or villages included 8 confederate clans, from whom the Vajis were most important. Vaji was also very important in Buddha period. Malla has been mentioned in the Buddhist and the Jain text. It is existed in a republic of 9 territories covering the modern district of Deoria. Kashi was located in the region around the Varanasi, which was bounded by the rivers Varuna and Ashi in the northern and southern capital at Varanasi. Kosla was located to the northwest of Magadha with its capital at Shravasti. Chedi, the capital of the Chedis was Suktimati, covering present-day Bundelkhand region. Chedi was ruled by Shishupala. Vatsa, it was a hub of all the economic activity, business and trade covering modern district Allahabad. Mirzapur with its capital of Kushambi. Kuru belonged to the Puru Bharata family. These were the people who originated from the Kurukshetra and their capital was at Indraprastha. Panchala covered by the area of present western UP and the east of river Yamuna up to Kosala Janapada. Susena, it witnessed great metamorphism in religion. The capital of Surasena was Mathura. Matsya, it's what located to the south of Kuru and west to the river of Yamuna, covering in the area of Alwar, Bharatpur and Jaipur in Rajasthan.